Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back to the channel and I hope you're all doing well. In this video, we're going to take a look at focal length. So you might think that focal length is really only important if you're a photographer or maybe even some kind of traditional 2D artist. However, focal length is very important if you're a 3D or visual effects artist, and in this video, I'm going to talk about why. So in this video, we're going to take a look at what focal length is, how increasing or decreasing the focal length affects the image, and why it's so important to understand. That sounds interesting. Let's get started. When light rays hit a camera lens, they converge at a focal point, and the focal length refers to the distance from the focal point of the lens to the camera sensor. In older cameras, instead of the sensor, it would be the film. So as the focal length increases, the angle of view, or what you can see through the lens, decreases, and the foreshortening decreases as well, and vice versa. For example, with an ultra-wide angle, a small focal length, the angle of view is large, and therefore more of the subject can be shown in the frame. Foreshortening is also increased, meaning that objects closer to the camera look much larger and more distorted than they do to the human eye. This is especially noticeable with vertical lines, which appear to angle inwards or outwards if the camera is tilted up or down, respectively. With a super telephoto lens, or a lens with a large focal length, the angle of view is much smaller. There's very little foreshortening here, and the subject will appear to be flattened. So let's have a look at these images here that I created in Maya. And with these various images, I have specific focal lengths, and notice what happens as we go through each one. So starting off with a 10mm lens, this is considered an ultra-wide angle lens, we can see all the way down the street, and we can see two distinctive vanishing points. So if you remember from like a drawing class, you might have learned how to do two-point perspective. When you are practicing two-point perspective, what you're basically representing is an ultra-wide angle lens. Otherwise, you would need a very, very large piece of paper and your focal points would be very, very far apart. Looking at this first one here, the viewer or the camera is basically at that intersection and we can see all the way down both streets. So next, we have an 18mm lens, which is slightly further back. And as we increase the focal length to a 24, which is a wide angle lens, we have to step back from the road. We no longer can see down the street and there are vanishing points are further apart. Notice also what happens to the building. It appears to be slightly more flattened, there's less distortion. Now as we increase that to a 35mm lens, which is still wide angle, the vanishing points are much, much further away, and we have to be even further back. So as we increase, we're magnifying the view. Our angle of view decreases, so we have to stand further away from the subject to keep it in frame. Otherwise, we'd get something like this, where we're just zooming into the shot. Next, we have a 50mm lens. This is going to be closer to what the human eye will see, and notice how far away we are from the subject. We also have an 85mm lens here. And lastly, we have telephoto lenses. So we have a 120mm lens, which is a short telephoto lens, and then we have a 300mm, which is considered more like a super telephoto lens. So as we increase the focal length to a 600, then a 900, and then finally a 1200mm lens, we get to the point where we could almost mimic an orthographic view, which has equal foreshortening in all three axes. So this is very, very important for 3D artists, especially for visual effects artists, because it is vital that you match the focal length of the plate when setting up a camera in a 3D scene. Otherwise, 3D objects composited onto the plate won't look correct. So you either need to know exactly what the focal length was of the plate, or you need to create objects that match objects in the scene, and then make a camera that seems to line up with everything in the scene. Sometimes this is quite tricky to do. In some of the tutorials of this channel, we have discussed how to set up a scene like this. If you take a look at the sniper one and the one about the plane. So in the last tutorial series, I discussed the importance of focal length when setting up a camera for an aerial aviation shot. And in this, I discussed that the focal length needs to be increased. Otherwise, if it's too wide angle, it's going to look unrealistic. And the reason is, with a wide angle lens, you physically have to be closer to the subject. And if your cameraman is in another plane filming the subject plane, it would be way too close. And this is something that you need to keep in mind, even if it's a full CG visual effect shot. So in summary, as the focal length increases, vanishing points move farther away, field of view decreases, foreshortening or distortion decreases, the subject would appear to be flatter in this case, and the subject appears to be larger in frame and more zoomed in. So unless you stand back, it's going to be magnified in frame. Likewise, as the focal length decreases, vanishing points move closer together, your field of view increases, foreshortening or distortion increases, the subject in this case would have more depth, and then the subject appears to be smaller in frame or more zoomed out, so you physically have to get closer to the subject in order to fill the frame. Alright guys, thank you so much for watching. Hope you guys learned something. If you did, drop a like. If you have any questions, post a comment, and I'll see you next time. Peace.